Hi you guys, it's Bria Gabe and I want to talk to you guys about motherhood basically today. So today I was on this wives and mothers page that I follow on Instagram. It's literally, I think, called wives_and_mothers. I think that's it. If I could remember the post or if I have it in my phone, I'll insert it here. So, the post basically was like that the mother left her 8-month-old son or baby to, I don't know where, but the, okay, let me start over. Okay, the post basically said that the mother left her 8-month-old baby, who she was breastfeeding, to go and find her ex at the club. And then it was attached to the picture, and it said that her husband came and found her, whatever, and beat her up or whatever. So it showed a picture with her with a swollen eye. Not sure if you guys saw it or not, but I did. So it just upset me when there were a lot of people that said that she deserved it, etc., etc. But there's a lot of guys out there that do the cheating and they don't get beat up. What do they get? So I feel like nobody deserves that no matter what. But that's not what I came on here to talk about today, okay? I didn't come on to talk about it. A lot of people in the comments were saying different stuff about how because she was breastfeeding, she's not allowed to leave the baby, blah blah. And it just irked me because I thought about it. I was like, okay, I breastfeed my son, he'll be 1 next month on the 11th. So I was like, wait a minute, so I have to be attached to my child 24/7 because I'm breastfeeding? That's not how that works. Like, I'm not the only person who came up with my child, blah blah. So then I commented on it and everything, and I was saying different stuff about it. And someone else, she was like, well, she left her baby hungry at home to follow after an ex. And I was like, the ex part, she was wrong for that. She was like, there's no going around that. She was wrong. But it irked me because of the fact that nowhere in there does it say that her baby was hungry. Your 8-month-old baby doesn't eat as much as your 8-day-old baby would. So it just made me feel like, okay, my son, when he was 8 months, he still ate a good amount, I want to say, but not just over the top, because he was getting introduced to solids and stuff like that. So normally we could go about 4 hours without him eating, right? He won't take a bottle or anything like that with the milk in it. Like, I just recently started getting him to drink a sippy cup, like the one with the straw. I just recently got him to start even drinking whole milk out of that. So I was like, there are other options. Like, it's not that she just left the baby hungry, because say she had to went to the grocery store and she wanted to go by herself, she needed a break. So, oh well, she has to take the baby with her everywhere she goes 24/7 while the dad doesn't have to. And I guess it just frustrated me because of the fact that in the beginning, my son, everywhere I went, he went with me. Like, it was so hard for me to not even to let him stay with his dad. Like, everywhere he went with me. Like, everywhere I went, he was there. Like, there's no doubt about it, you were gonna see him if you saw me. And so it just, I want to say, and that was about until 6 or 7 months, when I was like, okay, well, I can leave Trey for a little bit and do something else, or I can leave him for a second and go and actually get my nails done or something like that, or I can go out and have a nice time or something like that, right? Like, even when I went home, when he was about 5 months, I went home, I didn't even leave him with my family, because I felt like, oh well, I had him and I'm supposed to have him with me all the time. But when you do that, when you have your child with you all the time and you have no breaks, it can leave you feeling like really depressed. It can leave you feeling like you're only a mom, like you can't be anything else, you have to only be a mom. And that's not true, because before you were a mom, you were a woman, you were possibly a wife, I'm not sure or not, but there were other things that you were before that in your whole existence. Like, of course he means the world to me, but that doesn't mean that he has to be attached to me 24/7. I'm not sure if you guys get what I'm saying or if I'm just rambling, but I was like, let's do a motherhood mommy talks kind of video or whatever, since that just grinded my gears and whatnot. It's just like, I don't understand, because one person, she commented to me or whatever, that basically her child is 2, and she was like, well, my child is 2 and I still breastfeed and everything like that, and that she only leaves for work. And I commend her for breastfeed up until 2, because I want to stop once she turns 1. So that's great that she does breastfeed up until 2 and everything like that, or she's still breastfeeding as her child is 2. But she does leave for work. Since I stay home with my son, even when I was working, I worked from home. Ever since I had him, I have not left the house to work. I worked from home and everything like that, but I haven't worked from anywhere else. And so it's just like, with being with him and stuck in the house all day, because for work, I would work from 12:30 to 9. So literally in the morning we woke up, I had time to make breakfast, start preparations for dinner, and then I had to basically get ourselves together and everything like that. Then I had to clock in for work. After that, I couldn't leave the house. I had to stay in the house the whole time until nighttime. By the time 9 o'clock came, most places are closed unless you're trying to go to Walmart or something. So it didn't give me a lot of options to get out of the house. And so I feel like I want other mothers to know that it's okay to leave your child, because I feel like I just had to be with him all the time. And I feel like if I had seen someone say, okay, no, it's normal to just leave your child, like, you don't have to be with your child all the time, like, you need a break, moms need a breather too, like, you're allowed to go out for an hour without your child, you're allowed to leave your child with their father, like, you're allowed that, like, the father helped make the baby, right? So the father can help take care of the baby. And it's like, the more I've come to terms with that, of course it's hard now because my son is so attached to me, so he'll cry if I leave him. But it's like, so it's like if I had left him more in the beginning and let him have more time alone with his dad, then it wouldn't be as hard because he'd be fine with being left with his dad. But so that's another thing, like, he's gonna, if you only with your child 24/7 and your child only knows you, they're only gonna want to be with you, they're not gonna want to be with anyone else, which is gonna be harder in the long run, because when your child's 1 and 2 years old, your child's not gonna want to be anywhere else. And it's like, you can't not work forever, you can't be with your child forever. So yeah, I don't know what else to say about this topic. It's just, it was like, when I read it, I was like, I should really do a video on this, because this is something that is important to me, and it is something that other moms do need to hear, that it's okay to not be with your child 24/7. Of course, in the early days, you're going to be with your child all the time because you're trying to make sure that they get everything they need. You guys see my secret, that this whole entire time I've been holding him. Which probably isn't the best, but yeah, I've been holding my sleeping baby this entire time. Awkward. But yeah, no, lately, of course, I've been giving him time to be with his dad and everything like that without me. But it's like the other day, it was funny because I was in the living room and I was gonna go and get something, so I could fry some chicken, some oil, so I could fry some chicken. And I didn't want to take my son because I didn't feel like, I just didn't feel like taking him. I was like, I could run in and out in 2 minutes. Like, the store's 2 minutes up the street, I can run in and out and I'll be back, right? So I was like, okay, then babe, you can keep him with you and everything like that. And so then, he tricked Trey. He was like, okay, come on. And so he bribed him with candy. He's like, Trey, look what I have. Because Trey clearly likes candy, like his mother and father, and like his grandmother. I know my mom loves chocolate and stuff, but he bribed him with the candy. And so Trey had went all the way back to where he was, and then I snuck out and everything. But I forgot my glasses. But yeah, that's a whole different story for another day. And when I got back, he didn't even notice I was gone. So I was like, okay, so he's doing better. He is. It's just a matter of time. And it's like, it's not all bad that, of course, my son is mad attached to me. Like, I love that he's attached to me for the most part because he's my child. It's just sometimes I do need 2 seconds to breathe. I do want 2 seconds to myself. Like, literally, when I see memes that be like, oh, well, I can never have time to myself, be like, what do you mean? Of course you have time to yourself. You guys, legit, I have no time to myself. My son naps when I nap. If I'm going to sleep, then he'll go to sleep. If I wake up, he's going to wake up. If I'm not holding him, guess what? He's not staying asleep. If I go put him in that bed, he's going to wake up within 2 minutes. Like, he won't stay in there, and that's kind of sucks, but he's my baby, and it won't be like this forever, hopefully. But, yeah, so whenever I see memes or something like that before I have him, I'd be like, of course you, like, have time to yourself. What do you mean? Like, you get to shower, you get to do this, that, and third. Y'all, if I go shower, this boy gotta come with me, unless his dad is home. If his dad is home, then of course he'll get him, but if he's not, he showers with me. If I gotta use the bathroom, and I leave him watching, like, his little shows, because he loves his shows, guess what? He gonna crawl in there. As soon as he see me not in the room, he crawls to wherever I go. He can walk and everything, but crawling gets him to where he needs to be faster, so if I'm already out of sight, he'll crawl to me instead of walk. And yeah, I don't know, I feel like doing motherhood or mother types of videos, it helps me to get things that I'm thinking out or that I'm feeling out, and I feel like that's helpful. So I like doing these videos, even though this is the first video specifically like this. So you guys, if you guys did like this video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. If you have any comments to add on to what I was saying, or if you feel differently or anything like that, leave it in the comments below. We can discuss this. And also, if you would like to see more content or future videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button so you'll be notified of all of my new videos. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.